What's going on, everybody? This is Coach Reg, aka Mr. Intensity, and my job is to invoke thought and help awaken the world's consciousness one person at a time. Hopefully that person is you. Now, we went into the GMOs and what they're doing to the food, and we know it's very bad. You probably look into your cabinet right now and realize that there's a lot of ingredients in your food that have GMOs in it, which leads me to my next topic of why I went vegetarian. You know, you're like, you see me in my previous videos last year, and I'm eating packs of chicken, like whole packs of chicken, and I'm doing pretty good. I'm bulking, I'm healthy. I seem to be, you know, at the best shape of my life, and then all of a sudden I go missing, and then I come back as a vegetarian. And why I went vegetarian, I want to go over in this video. I'm going to be totally transparent. I'm going to be 100% real with you. If you're on Instagram right now, go ahead and click on my video, you know, to go on YouTube. But besides that, let's get into why I went vegetarian. And I'm going to be totally transparent with you. I haven't really reviewed what I'm going to say in this video, so this is pretty much unthought about, unfiltered. I'm going to pretty much break down my full experience of when I started to me being vegan. Now, last year, back in August, I was doing great, you know, with meat. I was doing, you know, 2 packs of chicken a day. Easy, okay? Intermittent fasting. I'm gonna keep my tea in my hand. I had my results. I was doing great. You know, my body fat was at 10%, 8%, and I really had no problems. And I was doing intermittent fasting about 24 hours a day. You see my previous videos. I was really cut at that point, and I was bulked at the point, and I've never been the strongest in my life. And I went to a seminar, and it had nothing to do with health. It was a real estate seminar because I want to open a gym, and I want to, you know, when you want to become wealthy and successful, you want to do it with multiple streams of income. So I went to this seminar, and he opened my eyes to a lot of things that I didn't know. You know, it had something to do with finance, you know, and that led me to my spiritual awakening. And I will get into my spiritual awakening in a whole nother video, because that's a whole nother experience. But when you are spiritual, you try to, you know, one of the first things about being spiritual is the way you eat. And when I start listening to people on YouTube, like Infinite Waters and Nasir Ra, I'm not sure if you know these people, but, you know, they, you know, Nasir Ra wasn't, you know, a vegetarian, but it was more about what you eat. And Infinite Waters, you know, I'm like, why is this guy? He seems to be, like, I saw his videos before, you know, in the beginning when he started, and I had my YouTube station. It was, you know, building, still building, very much so. And he just looks different. He seems like he feels different. And everybody's like, you know, feed your spirit body. I'm like, what's your spirit body? I don't understand. Like, what's your spirit body? So more and more people started to talk to me on YouTube through that, and I started to do my research on why they're so adamant about being vegetarian. Because if you're like me, you're wondering, like, being vegetarian means that you can't bulk. Being vegetarian means that you're going to always be hungry. Being vegetarian means that your lifestyle is about to get hella uncomfortable, because there's nobody really around you that probably is a vegan. So it was pretty scary for me, because I never, like my fiance, she's a vegetarian. She's been a vegetarian for 6 years, and I always try to get her to eat meat, because sometimes it got hard for her, you know, but she's pretty much held it together, and she never broke for me. She never broke. Never broke. Now, all the meat, I even had her cooking meat for me, and she still didn't break, okay? It used to make her feel nauseous, you know, eating meat. And I said, okay. I had experienced pescatarian before, and it was hard. I'm like, yo, I need more than just fish. Like, I'm kind of getting bored with fish. And the price of salmon, it seems to be, you know, it was really expensive. So I'm like, how am I going to maintain a vegetarian lifestyle? Because everything that you would want to eat healthy is always expensive. It's always expensive. You go to the health food store, it's just like 2 times the price of everything that you normally would get, you know, from the supermarket. So it's like, okay, I'm not broke, but I'm not trying to spend all my bread on food. I don't want to do that. So why become a vegetarian? Well, I did more research. And I did research first. It was about animals, right? And somebody had showed me a video before about them murdering animals. I knew they took little chickies and put them in a blender why they were alive. I knew they killed the chinchillas and pulled the skin back on them, and you know why they were alive, and seeing them blank with no skin on them, and turn the cows upside down and just cut their throats, and you know, and hit them with the in the head with the hole puncher thing, the door puncher. I knew what they did. I already knew it. And it didn't really affect me because I loved meat that much. And I didn't really care. But I was on the verge of having a Kundalini spiritual awakening, which was going to start making me see things through my third eye. And that's where it started to become a vegan. Because I always always knew that I was destined to do great things. And I always knew that I had intuition that you couldn't understand when it comes to questioning things. And I knew that I had to become more than what I currently was. Because what I was going through at the point was like I was trying to figure out where I was going with my career in fitness, because it no longer became fun to me. It became business, and you know, my partner started to branch off from me and do their own thing, and you know, I'm like, well, that's cool because that's what you're supposed to do. You know, supposed to transcend, but still, it wasn't a comfortable situation for me because I was left to try to figure out what do I do with the business and how do I maintain the business without all my partnerships that I had built and put a lot into building, you know, and what do I do? So I looked into your pineal gland, and it talked about opening your third eye. And I'm like, what is that? That's some other stuff. I don't want to get into that. But I was like, you know what? Let me be open-minded and get into opening my third eye and why it's not open. Because I always thought that I have a little the psychic ability, and every time I went to go see a psychic, they always said that I had some type of ability. And pretty much I wanted to look into it. So I looked into it, and well, they said first things first, you gotta decalcify your pineal gland. I'm like, well, why do I gotta decalcify it? Because it's been fully calcified since I've been 12. I'm like, since I've been 12, that's crazy. And they talked about how they calcify your pineal gland. And it comes from fluoride, because fluoride is the number one ingredient to calcify your pineal gland. So I'm like, well, fluoride, that's in toothpaste. That's cool. And they said, I looked into it and come and find out fluoride is not cool. Fluoride is the number one ingredient to calcify, and they put it everywhere just to calcify. I'm like, wow. So they really, it's a war against my pineal gland. What's the big deal about a pineal gland inside your head? I looked into that, and that's where your psychic ability comes from. That's where your spiritual ability will come from. And I wanted to become closer to my spirit side, because if there's a way that I can talk to people who have passed and do astral projection and lucid dreaming, well, I'm going to do that. And I have done both of those since then. And I wanted to literally leave my body and have an out-of-body experience as well. And, you know, I'm like, okay, I looked into having an out-of-body experience. So I started reading Robert Greene's books, and you know, everybody talks about you got to start changing your diet. Like, dramatically, you got to change your diet. So, it was a no-brainer. Without doing any real research about being a vegetarian or a vegan, I said, I'm going straight vegan. And I went straight, full-force vegan. Okay? I stopped eating meat. I stopped eating fish. I was eating nothing but beans and rice and having protein shakes. I went to go buy some protein shakes from the Whole Foods store. Around my way at the time, it was Big Bear Whole Foods, and I was just eating protein shakes, beans, and rice, and whatever else my fiance had made for me. And it got boring. It got very boring very quick, and I started losing weight. My mom, friends, and family noticed it, and you know, when you're somebody who grew up skinny, you don't, and you bulked up, and you got nice and cut and everything. Like, I was a toothpick when I was a kid, like a toothpick. Pick. And you can't tell my build by having a shirt on and everything. Right now, you could still think I'm skinny, but I got muscles under the shirt now. I'm just very aesthetic in tone. I never wanted to be a bodybuilder. I never wanted to be like some huge giant bodybuilder where I can't even brush my hair and my arms are out here, because I always knew that when they get in their 50s, it's kind of hard to maintain that muscle. And then when you get older, your muscle deteriorates and it turns to fat. So I wanted to be more aesthetic than anything. I wanted to be more physically cut because I'm a basketball player. And I wanted to just be cut. So the way I was bulking was perfect for me, because I always would stay under 200, but always above 180. And then I looked at the scale one day and it says 168. And I'm like, yo, I have been losing weight. And even my fiance, she not going to tell me. She not going to tell me. But I know when she looks at me, when I was bulking. She's always makes like comments and things of that nature. And she stopped making those comments like I was diesel. So I'm like, I must be losing weight. So my mom said I was losing weight. My dad's wife said I was losing weight. And my fiance don't really make that many comments about me anymore. So I started to become self-conscious. And I was like, I started to eat fish again. I started to eat fish again. And it was around the holidays. So I was being tempted a lot when it comes to chicken. Because I like fried chicken. I like ham. I like turkey. And I really was focused on opening my pineal gland. So I started to, take spirulina. And I started to take, oh, I had anti-fluoride toothpaste. And I started taking cold showers so the fluoride from the water wouldn't get in my skin. I was going in, but psychologically, it was putting me in a stress state where I probably could binge later on. I always tell my clients that, when you go straight clean out of going, instead of going progressively to clean, psychologically, if you go to cold turkey, it's going to put too much stress on you and you will binge, and you won't just binge, you will binge heavy. And since I couldn't eat meat, I started to binge with snacks and stuff like that. I started to eat snacks. I started to drink a little bit. It was stressing me out. And sometimes the drinking would, like liquor would, I'm a fitness guy, so I got to maintain that. But nobody was seeing me because I wasn't making no videos. I wasn't doing my classes. And I was kind of staying, I was just, I mean, my sons have football, so I wasn't really playing basketball that much on the weekends either. People, and I was always just wearing coats. It was the winter time, so nobody could really see my body. So it was a great time to hide. If you're going to ever be in a state of depression or anxiety, you don't want nobody to see your body, do it in the wintertime. But I don't suggest you do it at all. But I was going through a little bit of anxiety and depression at that point where I really didn't know what was going on with me. I was like, okay, I want to be more in touch with my spiritual self. And I know the main part to be in touch with my spiritual self is to open up my pineal gland and to decalcify my pineal gland. But this way is kind of hard for me. So how, what am I going to do? Because I really don't want to be a vegetarian. I just want to be a vegetarian because of what they do to the animals. Now let's get into the next part about why I became a vegetarian. They say when that energy is not lost nor destroyed, it's only transferred from one object to the next. You know that from Albert Einstein, but it's 100% true. Law of attraction. I started to study that stuff and energy and spirit and frequency and vibration. And I started listening to Abraham Hicks. If you don't know who that is, that's the person behind Abraham Hicks. Esther Hicks channels Abraham, and that's what they call a mass consciousness. You should look it up. Oprah interviewed Abraham Hicks. Esther Hicks is. As Abraham, who was a consciousness, channeled through Esther. And that, if you ever read The Secret, the person who wrote The Secret, all her ideas behind The Secret came from Esther Hicks channeling Abraham. This might sound weird for you, but you should go look it up because it's really not weird, especially when I did the astral projection and I found out what really was going on when it comes to life and death and all that stuff. And it put me to a state where I questioned everything that I currently was doing, currently believed in. But I'll get into that in another video because I have to really think about how I'm going to put that out there because I'm going to infuriate a lot of people close to me. And that's later on. But right now, if you kill an animal, if you raise that animal their whole lives in like a mass farm, that animal's energy is torture. That animal's energy is depression. That animal's energy is troubling. Okay, it's stress. So that is the animal's energy. That becomes the animal. And then you pump that animal full of drugs to keep it alive and to keep it able to produce what you need to take from it. Right? And then you murder that animal with a tragic death. That animal's energy, the animal's soul was gone. But that animal's frequency of that meat is still in that meat. Okay, because animals do have a soul. Don't tell me when you look in the eyes of an animal doesn't have a soul. An animal has a soul. That's why they're all different. Animals have personalities. Cats have personalities. Dogs have personalities. They have personalities. They have souls. And when you kill that animal and you take that meat has a certain frequency to it. And then you eat that meat. Well, you take on that frequency. And if you've been doing this for years and you've had like, issues when it comes to temper and other frustration things and depression, it could be coming from the food. And I had to make my spirit totally clear, of pretty much what that animal was. Now, I don't want to be a vegetarian. This is not by choice. This is because they're killing and doing what they're killing and doing to the animals. They're pumping them full of stuff. It's like slavery to me, because I've researched it and it's a lot like slavery. They put us in farms. They made us work. They took from us. They took our life from us. They sold us. They transferred us. They just didn't eat us. Our energy was depressed. Our energy was sad. Our energy was distress. No, they didn't pump us full of drugs in that time. They do it in different ways now through the prisons. And where that's legal slavery through prisons. If you do something bad, you got to go to prison and you become a slave all over again. You lose your freedom. Now, it's a lot like slavery, and I couldn't ride with that. Now, I don't want to be a vegetarian, but I did research on it. We don't have to eat meat anymore. We became vegetarian because, I mean, we became carnivore. Well, we started eating meat because we started to travel the globe, and we just, we had found animals. We used them as food. But even when we did kill those animals, we used them for something. We used them for fur. We used them for food. We didn't just kill them just to mass produce them like we are now. And the food that they're making is not always 100% what you think it is. The salmon has been genetically engineered. So literally, salmon is not even real salmon. A lot of chicken is not even real chicken. They're genetically engineering all this stuff a lot. And they're pumping it full of GMOs anyway. So I didn't want to put that into my body because it would mess up my spirit. And I don't want to mess up my spirit by putting spirit of and animals that have been tortured in my body. So I decided not to be a vegan. Now, like I made in my previous video, if I see a deer in my backyard right now, that deer has lived a good life. That deer has lived a free life. That deer has been eating nature its whole life. That deer is clean. I will take a bow and arrow and I will kill that deer. And the only bad part about that deer is the death of the deer. But the death is fine because, like I said, I'm gonna avatar them and finish them off and not torture them. And that's that. That's the only time I'm gonna eat meat if it's this wild caught game, fish, venison, deer, or whatever is caught that's wild after a great free life. I'm gonna go ahead and eat that. Otherwise, I'm not eating meat anymore. And that's why I stopped eating meat. I went pescatarian for a little while, but my spirit told me to stop eating this. It didn't feel right. I started eating shrimp. I'm like, I feel like I'm eating something that's alive right now. And it did, and I didn't feel good when I did that. I just spilled something on my shirt anyway. So that's pretty much why I stopped eating meat. I pretty much let you in today. What happened in my life when it comes to the spiritual awakening? I'll talk about that in a later video because that's a lot, and I'm still currently going through the spiritual awakening. If you ever heard of chakras, I opened up all my chakras. This is your crown chakra. This is your set. Was it not your sacral? I forget. I gotta go through them again. But this here is my pineal gland. I opened up this. This is my third eye chakra. But you have chakras, here, your throat chakra. Your throat chakra, once I opened that up, I had the ability to express more. I believe my throat chakra was always open because I always had the ability to speak, But the way I spoke before wasn't like I'm speaking now. I have no filter when it comes to the things that I say. And before I was afraid of speaking like this and telling you the truth and telling you my truth, but if I always wanted to be a speaker, you got to keep it real with all the people that you're talking to. Before I was more, if you should tell, you could tell in my videos before, I was more of motivation and being trying to not offend anybody. But that's when you have no offend, when you don't offend anybody, you kind of offend everybody by not being yourself. So now I'm just more open and honest with my videos. They're longer, but I mean, it is what it is. This is my truth. This is me. This is Coach Reggie, My job is to invoke thought, like I say in my videos. My job is to invoke thought. And I went vegan because I want you to think about being a vegan. I mean, I want vegetarian because I want you to think about, being a, I keep on saying vegan, vegetarian. It's not the same thing. Vegan is when you eat straight raw greens, raw stuff all the time. Vegetarian is when you still consume dairy from time to time. I don't drink milk. I don't eat cheese. I eat non-dairy cheese. I drink almond milk. I eat beans. I still eat rice, but I like to eat quinoa because rice is a GMO as well. I'll eat the 100% organic GMO free meat. It has to have the certified sticker because you can go into the vegetarian section right now and shop right, and it will say gluten free to throw you off, and but you read the back of it. It has soy, canola oil, soy flour, soy products, everything that you is consider a GMO right now. So you gotta really look for it. But it gets really expensive when you start to do it that way. What else do I eat? I try to eat less bread, like protein bread, but I looked at my protein bread and that also has soy and soy flour, all that stuff. So I buy bread. What else do I eat? I eat a lot of veggie dishes. Like my girl, my fiance, I keep on saying girl. You say fiance, but she makes these sandwiches for me, and they're straight veggies. You got mushrooms, you got spinach, you got kale, you got tomatoes, you got onions, you got your spices, and it's really filling. She makes a lot of it, and it's really filling because, and I get my protein from it, which is a great thing. I get my protein from it. So, I mean, if you got somebody that cooks, marry her. Marry her. Because I could tell you without her, I wouldn't be able to do this. I would not be able to be to maintain. Well, I would find strength, but it's easier when you have somebody that's with you and they're doing it with you. Because if you're with somebody and you try to be vegetarian and they're still eating meat, it's really hard because the meat is still around you at all times, and you gotta see it. And 9 times out of 10, you're probably gonna achieve this. The same thing when it comes to weight loss. If you're trying to lose weight, and you're with somebody that isn't losing weight or isn't trying to lose weight and they're still eating snacks all the time, it's very hard to do it because it makes your job 10 times harder if you gotta sit here and watch them eat the snacks that you used to love to eat, and then you can't eat it, so it puts a stress on you. Like, ah, I'm gonna go ahead and do it, and that's the beginning of your weight gain again, or whatever goal you have that you didn't want to have before. I mean, whatever goal that you have that you didn't want to, that you wanted to hit, it's that's the beginning of the end, okay? Besides that, let's talk about what else do I eat? I eat a lot of greens. I don't like to eat red beans because they give me gas. Beans, they make you fart. I like to eat black beans. Not canned beans because that's also a GMO. So I eat the dry beans and she'll let them sit for a day so they can get soft. Chickpeas, no corn, done with corn, bye bye corn. I never like corn anyway. String beans, a lot of fruit, avocado for fat, coconut oil for fat. You got your MACA, you got your cacao shakes. I don't drink protein shakes anymore. Not even a vegetarian kind. I don't feel like it. I feel like I can do this journey, without any supplements whatsoever. Like, I don't know why I'm so hell-bent against supplements. I just feel like anything unnatural in your body might have something in it. When they say it's natural, it's not natural if it's genetically engineered. Even with the MACA powder, like, I make sure it's 100% MACA, 100% cacao, coconut oil. That's pretty much what I eat. Like, whatever she makes, I eat, but it's always a lot of veggies in it. And I try to give my kids, school lunches. I try to make them their own lunch. Since they started a new school, they don't eat school lunch because after they got sick from the old school, when something was going around, they both got sick. That showed me, like, okay, I can't let my kids eat school lunch no more. Which I'll make another video about school lunch and why that's so bad for your children, putting out that low frequency food in your kids. But besides that, that's why I went vegan. That's what I went through, and I hope you can use my experience to help out you through your experience if you decide to go vegetarian, pescatarian, or anything. If you decide to go pescatarian, just make sure that you're doing research on the fish, where it came from. If you don't know where the fish came from, 9 times out of 10, it's GMO. or genetically engineered, like not even real salmon at all. You can kind of taste it sometimes too, especially the frozen salmon. A lot of that stuff isn't even real. But I'm going deep sea fishing this summer a couple times, and or this spring, and I'm going to catch a lot of fish. I'm going to put them in the freezer, and I'm going to eat them later. I like blue fishing because they're like this big, you know what I mean? And they do well. They taste really, really good too. Besides that, everybody have a great day. This is Coach Reg. My job is to invoke thought and help bring the world's consciousness one person at a time. Hopefully that person is you. Have a great day. I'll talk to you later. So come check me out tomorrow. Subscribe to my channel. Like, comment, criticize, ask questions. I love questions. As soon as you ask questions, I get right back to you. Besides that, oh, also I do nutritional programs, training. I don't really do the classes anymore, but if you want personal training, you're close enough, I'll personal train you. I walk through the nutritional program wherever you are. I've never seen anybody I couldn't help. If you're 300, if you're 100 pounds, it doesn't matter. I can help you out, and I'll teach you how to live this healthy lifestyle, and I'll coach you through the whole process until you reach your goals. Everybody have a great day. I will talk to you later. Subscribe to my channel. Let's go, y'all.